As you guys know, Floyd Mayweather and 50 Cent are having a Twitter war. Well, I went to the expert of Twitter, to the Twitter king himself, Paulie Malignaggi, to have him break down this beef. Check it out. On the phone with us is the Twitter king himself, Paulie Malignaggi. First of all, Paulie, as the king of Twitter, I gotta ask you this. What do you make of the beef between 50 Cent and Floyd Mayweather? What do you make of it?
I just think, well, 50 Cent is kind of always having this boundary. You don't want to come into the hill business and burn your bridges real fast. You don't ever want to burn your bridges, but the way 50's handling things, you know, he's burning bridges real fast. And it's not going to be good for the fighters he's got signed on the contract, and that's the one that I feel bad for, the fighters, you know. This is not the rap game. This is not some other kind of business. Boxing is very difficult to deal with, and just because you have money or just because you're famous doesn't mean you're actually going to be successful in it, you know. The way he's going to lose a lot of money in this business. And, you know, he's burning the wrong bridges. He's burning some pretty powerful bridges, and it's going to be hard to turn back for him, man, if he continues this way.
Paulie, is there any etiquette? Because I've seen you have Twitter wars from people in England to other fighters. What's the do and don't do when you have a Twitter battle?
Well, you know, you gotta kind of play it by ear, I guess, so to speak. But, you know, a situation with 50, when he's new to this business, you can't come in like gangbusters and just try to, you know, throw everybody out and basically come in like you're going to be the king of it. This business is, you know, whoever succeeds in this business built the foundation through a lot of years. You don't just come in and succeed, you know. Even Golden Boy Promotions, how powerful they are now, you know, they started with a little book sale, they ordered on HBO Latino, remember in the beginning, and, you know, they kind of built this empire they have now. All big time success stories in boxing, as far as promotional companies and managerial companies, you know, they come up the slow way, you know. Even if you come up with some momentum, you still gotta do things right. You definitely don't wanna come in and burn your bridges with the powerful people when you're just a newcomer. It doesn't matter who 50 Cent is. This business, he's nobody, you know what I mean? And if he continues to burn these bridges, he's gonna be a nobody, he's gonna be out of it real fast, you know? It's a situation where, you know, to be successful, a lot of times you gotta step over people and step on people. I feel like 50 Cent has had a lot of success in his life. He's burned a lot of his bridges in other businesses. He's stepped over people. He's stepped on people. He's kind of screwed people over. And, you know, a lot of times that happens when people are successful, but, you know, it's not just going to continue to work. Eventually, I set it up to you if you keep doing it for the wrong people. You know, Floyd Mayweather never needed 50 Cent. You know, it's kind of funny how one second 50 had nothing to do because he wasn't selling albums anymore. He wasn't making movies or anything, so he just hangs out with Floyd Mayweather all day and all night. And he thinks he's going to just break into the boxing business just by hanging out with Floyd Mayweather. And, you know, it comes down time to make a contract, and just because you don't get what you want out of the contract, you're just going to walk away and start stepping all over Floyd, the guy you were just hanging on to and hanging out with all the time. That's not how it works, you know. You gotta play your cards right, you know. And, you know, this isn't WWE where all of a sudden you become friends and all of a sudden there's a beef, you know. It's not like that. I mean, in real life, you get burned, man. And, you know, he's burning a lot of powerful bridges in doing what he's doing, and I could care less about him, really. It doesn't matter whether he has money to me or not. I care about the fighters that are signing with him, because, you know, the fighters always work hard, and they're willing to pay a price if the person they're signed to burns bridges like that.
And I have to ask you this about yourself. They're saying you might fight Ricky Hatton next. You fought Hatton in the past. He's fighting a guy you fought in the past. What do you think of that fight? Because it's two guys that you met in the ring with.
You know, I don't think the fight is very easy, but I do think in England, the Patton is tough to beat. I will also say Danchenko, who is a good fighter, is not the most mentally strong fighter, and 20,000 British fans inside the main arena, I don't think he's going to be very comfortable coming out to the ring and then hearing Ricky Hatton's ring walk. He kind of has a little bit of fold in him, although he is talented, and although I think he can trouble Ricky with a solid jab and all that stuff. But if he's nervous about going into that atmosphere at all, I mean, Ricky's going to walk all over him. It's not, it could be a good fight, but in the end, in England, it's tough to beat Ricky, because, you know, you're going to have to do those shady stuff, like I called the Juan Lascano fight, the Michu fight, where he was getting outgunned and they tied his shoe for 5 minutes. You know, even if they got to do a Michu situation again, Ricky will win in the end, because in England, he's tough to beat.
That's true. Now, I don't know if you remember this, but when I saw you in Vegas maybe 6 months ago, a year ago, I talked to Emmanuel Stewart, I talked to Nazim Richardson, I talked to other people in boxing, and they all told me that if you fought Floyd Mayweather, Paulie Malignaggi Mayweather, would be a very difficult fight for Floyd. So if you go in there and you Ricky Hatton moves, you beat Ricky Hatton, is that a fight that you'd be interested in?
Well, Anytime you can fight the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, it's always of interest to any fighter, you know? It's not often a fighter gets to test himself against the best of his generation. Floyd is the best of this generation, or maybe even the generation before. He's so good, he's been through two generations and been the best. So, you know, anytime you get to test yourself against somebody like that, you know, it's something that that it will always interest any competitor, any fighter. And obviously, yeah, I do think there are things in my style. And if I come in on a sharp night, what's trouble for it? Style may fight. You know, and I do think there are things that can trouble Floyd, but I do think Floyd is also the best fighter in the world. And, it's never easy getting in the ring with a guy like Floyd Mayweather.
And my last thing, I got to ask you this. You just came back from New York. Obviously, we all know about Sandy. How are things in New York right now, in New Jersey, in that area?
It's a little bit rough. We're trying to get through it day by day. Some people lost more than others, but everybody's lost a little bit. You know, it's just a matter of regrouping. And if you have your health and you have your life, you got to be thankful because not everybody made it out of that storm alive.
Thank you, Pauli. Any message to your fans?
Follow me at Paulie on Twitter.
So there you have it. Pauli Malignaggi talking 50 Cent, Floyd Mayweather. For usenreporting.com, I'm Ali Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback.